In this video, I'm going to show you how I use Opentrack and an Aruco marker for tracking head movements when playing IL-2 Sturmovik, Battle of Stalingrad. First thing to do, of course, is print yourself off an Aruco paper marker. I use this one. I will put a link to this website in the description below. I copied this image to my PC and then reduced its size just to make it a little bit smaller. Then I printed it onto some stiff paper, almost like card. You want it to be fairly sturdy so that it doesn't fold or bend whilst you're using it. Here is my Aruco marker with some dimensions to give you an idea of the size. I've left a border space around the edge so that I can attach paper clips to this without impacting on the marker itself. Then my method for getting this on my head is super low tech. I'm using a baseball cap and I've attached the marker to the strap at the back using paper clips. Notice how the marker is oriented when I'm wearing it. Next thing you're going to need is the Opentrack software, linked to this website below. It's freely available. You just want to find the latest version and download the Windows .exe file to install it on your system. Once you've installed it and opened the program, this is what you'll see. Let's create a new config. I'm going to call it test. You have a drop-down menu on the right there where you can select the different configs once you've created them. And then on the left, we need to select our input, which is going to be Aruco at the top there. And our output is already set to free track 2.0 enhanced, so you can leave that as it is. The filter I'm using is called Accela. Again, that's already set. Next, click on the hammer next to the input setting. You need to choose your webcam and then make sure you know your webcam's diagonal field of view and type that in to the box there. Then select the resolution you want to use for this. I use 640 by 480 and that seems to work pretty well. Check your camera settings and in particular whether you've got the correct power line frequency selected. I'm in the UK, so this needs to be 50 Hz, not 60. I don't change anything else on the camera settings. That's the tracker settings done. Just notice there's a toggle calibration button here, which we will come back to later. Moving on, the output settings, I just leave as they are. I don't really have any clue what any of this stuff does. Go into filter settings next, and there are a few useful things to do here. One is to create yourself a shortcut to toggle the tracking on and off. I'm using Shift and Q, and that's really handy to have in game to be able to toggle, because sometimes the tracking does go a little bit off and you need to reset it. Center at startup is ticked, and also centering method role compensated selected, and I just leave those as they are. Moving on to the output tab, I find I need to invert the yaw and the pitch, and that's probably because of how I've got the marker oriented when I'm wearing it, and it could be that I've got the marker oriented incorrectly, not sure. Relative translation I have enabled. I don't think it's that important a setting, and it just refers to the situation where you've turned your head to look behind you and then you're trying to move your head forwards or backwards. And then neck displacement. I don't really understand how this impacts things, but I have it enabled and I set it at 5 centimeters. Game detection I don't use, so I'll move on to the filter tab. And the default settings here are okay. I tend to reduce the dead zone a little bit, and that just helps keep the tracking smoother. And I also increase the smoothing to the max. I don't think it makes a huge amount of difference going to the maximum from where it was, but if you have those down at the minimum, it will be really shaky. So I just have them at the max and it seems to work okay. The options button here is just another way of accessing your filter settings. So let's go into mapping. This is an important section. I'm going to load up my IL-2 Aruco profile and show you how I've got each of my axes mapped. How this works is that for each axis you get a graph that you can alter. On the x-axis, your head movement in degrees, and on the y-axis is what that translates to in terms of in-game pilot head movement. So in this example for your, if I turn my head 20 degrees, that will correspond to my pilot turning his head 180 degrees. In other words, looking directly behind him, checking his six. You can change this max input angle if you want. I've got a 27-inch monitor, but if you've got a much larger monitor, you might want to try a slightly higher max input angle. It's also going to depend on how closely you're sitting to your monitor. You can change the shape of these curves. If you left click on the graph, it will bring up a dot that you can then move around. I tend to leave the curves fairly linear, but I have a small dead zone here, just 0.5. You might need to left click on the graph to get the dots, which you can then move around to create your dead zone. So now you understand how these graphs work, we can move on to the others. For pitch, you get a max input and a max output angle. I've set the max input to 15 degrees because I don't want to have to move my head up and down that much. And the max output, you've got a choice, either 90 degrees or 180 degrees. So I've gone for 180 degrees, and as before, I've got a small dead zone set. The difference on pitch compared to the other axes is that I've ticked the asymmetric mapping button, and that allows you to create a different mapping profile for tilting your head down compared to tilting your head up. And I've done that for a couple of reasons. Firstly, it feels a little bit easier on your neck. And secondly, sometimes you want to very quickly look down to your cockpit. So I've increased the gradient of the graph in the bottom half there to reflect that. I have a very shallow roll curve set. Roll refers to your head tilting left and right. Some people don't use roll, and if you don't want to use it, just drag the curve down to zero. Moving on to the final three, X, Y, and Z. These refer to your head moving side to side, up and down, or getting closer to the screen or further away. I've got all three of these set up the same way, a small dead zone, max input of 15 centimeters, corresponding to max output of 100 centimeters. You're almost done. Click on start and just check that the tracking works. As you move your head around, you'll see the octopus moving as well. There's one last thing to do, which is to calibrate the setup. So go to your input settings again, click on the toggle calibration button, then move your head around the screen using all of the different axes. Once you've done that for a while, click on toggle calibration again, and it will set these three values here. I don't know how they impact the setup, but once you've calibrated it, you can leave them as they are. And that is it. You're ready to play your game. Just remember to start the tracking before you load up the game. Comment below if I've missed anything. Many thanks for watching.